Hey everybody, it's Operation Destroy and welcome back to my channel, you guys. I feel good. I feel really good, you guys. As you may know, I've been away for a while and I just posted a Clash Royale video the other day, and I just want you guys to know that I'm still playing Boom Beach, as you can see here, and but I really have kind of lost interest in the game because, yeah, the Mega Crab is awesome. It only comes around once every blue moon, it seems. And I understand Supercell can only do so much. The last update with the storage statue, the statue storage, I don't find much need for it. I mean, I have a building health stored. I don't know why. I guess it's just because it's the 13% guardian, the highest you can get. However, since you can't swap statues and replace them, I find it not necessary because I already have my statues that I want. I'm not gonna give them up unless I get a better, you know, troop damage masterpiece or what have you, but that's easy. You just swap it out within the sculptor. So I don't know, like I said, I'm not a fan of it, so it's not really, it could be useful for some of them, but for some people, but for me, I just don't find any use for it. And also, you know, you got some of the graphics getting nerfed a little bit, the flamethrower. I don't have everything upgraded yet, guys. Like I said, I'm just, I haven't been playing Boom that much. As you can see, my victory points have dropped. I was above 900 the last time I posted a video on Boom Beach. So now I'm at 776. I'm now a General 3. I'm not even a Marshal anymore. So to become a Marshal, I gotta get to 820. So, but today, guys, I just got off watching Reversal's live Twitch stream. And like I say, man, Reversal, you are awesome. Thanks so much for your support, man. I really do appreciate it. And you guys, he got me thinking, you know what? I'm gonna boost my statues. And I did play in the task force. My task force, we did, I just used that boost in that operation. And I figured, you know what? I'm gonna do Smokey Hooka today, guys. Reversal was doing it, and I'm gonna show you my way of doing it. It's not any better, it's just my way of doing it. And I'm gonna try to clear all my player bases today using the Smokey Hooka, okay? So I only use two boats of heavies and the rest Zookas, because the more Zookas you have, the more damage you'll output. So anyhow, let's go find them, and I'm just gonna start over here in the icy area here. Let's check out Over Kickador. Let's check him out and see what we got here. Now, this is how I do it. When the HQ is in the center of the base, or the island, I basically want to get your Zookas either in one of the quadrants of the HQ. So, and when they're up in the right hand corner, like up in this area here, you want to obviously ride the sidelines and get there without going, because, you know, running your troops up through here, it can be kind of tricky because this is the way the buildings are placed. They might run in different zigzags and it can cause just a ruckus. But for now, I'm gonna have to run my troops up, and I'm trying to think the best way to do this would be to obviously artillery and get rid of this mortar here and place my troops somewhere up here where the boom cannon sniper tower are. That way there's nothing in the back really getting my girls, although the sniper towers will and so forth, but they're just one shots, not gonna do much. And then I just shock everything else. So let's do this, let's get right into this, and let me just plan. Here we go, let's do it. Let's go right in and try to take out this base here. So like I said, first foremost, I'm gonna actually artillery, and I might need to use another one, absolutely, yes. And if I get that flamethrower too, that'd be awesome, boom, okay. And I didn't check the rocket if it was gonna reach the beach, but we'll take a chance on that. So I'm gonna basically flare my troops, and I'm hoping that rocket's not gonna reach. I didn't measure it. Come on, get out. Let's just hope that rocket doesn't reach. Otherwise, my girls are gonna be toast, and they do reach. So let's just smoke, and then I'm actually gonna flare here now, so they kind of group. I'm gonna throw some critter boxes here, and then finally send them to the rest of their happy place over here to the see how they kind of run amok. So my troops now are going. Let me throw a med kit because we got some mines coming up, and I don't want my girls dying because that's the bulk of my army there. I do not want them to die. So with 74 GB, I did lose a few of my Zookas to some fire. So now I'm gonna flare back and flare to this core. Let's shock the shocks. The rockets go, send some critters out, and then just watch us take this base out, no problemo. Boom, down goes over Kickador. Yes, I just kicked a door down. Thank you so much. And I have my Power Stone chance boosted, so we'll see what we can get. And boom, lo and behold, I get a crystal, and I contribute that to my Power Stone chance boosted at 150%, you guys. So I'm happy with that. So let's move down the map here, the archipelago, or whatever you call that thing. That's a tongue twister, I tell you, for me. Okay, let's go to this guy here. Can't read his name, but he looks like... Okay, here's another base up the middle here, guys. He doesn't have any shield generator or anything. So I'm trying to figure out the best place to do this. I'm trying to think, yeah, basically I got the mortar, I can shock them, cool. I'm gonna go right underneath them. So what I'm gonna do is, since the rockets can reach the beach, I do a different strategy in actually getting to the HQ. So I'm gonna do a double barrage here over here at the boom cannon and the mortar. I'm hoping I can get all those taken out. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And then I'm gonna actually flare now right here and send two boats of critters to get rid of those mines, send my troops out, and do like more of a triangular smoke here, so my troops all get underneath there just fine. And then I'm gonna actually flare back so they can kind of group, and then flare them right to the HQ. Yes, there are some mines my troops will hit. I know that for a fact. And then now we are going to rest right here by the HQ. They are bunched right there, so I'm gonna actually flare them back in within that smoke, flare the core, start to begin my shock treatment on these guys, and let's see what we can do here, blasting away this HQ, no problem, right? Boom, and down goes this level 61 player, and let's see if my Power Stone chance gives me anything good here. Let's see, let's see, let's see. And I don't know. Did I get anything? Nothing. I got nothing, you guys. I go from getting a crystal to nothing. So it is what it is. So moving on down to this level 60 here. Let's check him out. He has a lot of loot to give away. I like that. This guy does now have a shield generator, one of those beams around his base. So this is one of the bases where I will actually approach from the right side. And my job here is to actually get rid of this flamethrower, probably this cannon as well, maybe double barrage here to do that and put my troops right there in the corner. I love corner bases, they are the best. So I'm going to do a double barrage here and see if we can get that mortar. Hopefully the mortar and flamethrower go for sure. The cannon will be like an extra bonus. Boom, just fine, perfect, I love it. And now the rockets are far back enough that nothing can hit my troops on deployment. Guys, deployment is very key when you don't have anything that can hit your troops. You need to deploy them so they all stick together, okay? Because then they go all crazy if you don't. So I'm actually gonna flare here like I'm doing the all Zuka run here, as you can see. You let your troops out as one, the head of each Zuka boat runs over each other. I let my heavies out at the same time even though they run faster because I want them ahead. I'm actually gonna critter those mines and flare to the actual point, the rendezvous point. And I'm gonna actually begin probably smoking about right now, and just keep my troops under the smoke. I do not want my troops out of the smoke. Doing fine so far. Do you notice they're running in a nice line as they go up the right side? All right, so now we got our troops going. My flare is just about to run out, so I'm gonna re-flare again so my Zukas make it there. And then once they get there, I'm going to actually flare the HQ. I'm gonna shock the shocks and some critters. And let's just take this base out, guys. Let's take it out. Let's take it out. Let's take it out. Yes, we are. So there goes this guy's base. Like I said, the corner bases are my best and favorite because I lose less troops. As you can see, I lost a heavy and I lost three Zukas. So it is what it is. Three Zukas, that's what I meant. So there we go, guys. And my treasure chest here, which is kind of cool. I got my reward, so I will take, I'll just take the diamonds, why not? Okay, and moving on, let's see, who should we go? Let's go to Arash, let's check him out, see where he's at. Wow, his base is like right in the front. He's like basically saying, come take my base from me. Okay, I will do that, no problem, my friend. So here I'm going to just basically just get rid of this flamethrower, place my troops there, That mortar can't reach unless they're back far enough, but I don't think they will be. And we should be good. So I can actually shock here, shock this rocket and this shock launcher, and get this one, and get this one over here. And we're pretty much golden. We'll probably lose a few troops, not too bad. Now this rocket can reach, it actually really, it almost can't, but I'm actually going to just do it. Let's just do it, guys. Let's just do it. I'll even throw one smoke where I'm gonna actually go, so that rocket, just in case it does hit me, because it is actually boosted with an amplifier, so I don't want that hitting my girls. Do not want that hitting my girls. So, and let's throw some critters here to get rid of these mines. Flare here and smoke here and let the troops out. Let my girls out here and let them come. That mortar though is actually probably in vicinity. And let's smoke our troops now to that location. And as you see, look how they're bunched up. See that makes it a lot easier when you're smoking your troops. You have no issues whatsoever. And then they're gonna, look how they just round that corner nice and easy. My Zookas hopefully won't hit that. Okay, they did, or my heavies did. All right, so now I'm gonna flare back and then flare to this core, and I'm gonna start my shocking of the rockets. The mortars need to go. And that flamethrower did get a piece of my Zookas, but we are taking this base down. I'll throw an extra med kit on my girls. And yes, we did lose a lot more troops than I imagined or thought, but whatever, we got the job done and that is it. So boom, I love the loot. I will take all that loot. Thank you so much. And so moving on, let's get this going. And we're going to see the general now. Doesn't offer that much gold, but we'll try it. Oh, this one is obvious where we're gonna stand. We're gonna stand in the back. As long as I get rid of that mortar, we are good. So I'm gonna actually, let's do that. And let me see here. I can probably just shock that. Perfect, okay. So, and the rockets, you always wanna test that to see where they reach. Okay, they don't reach the beach that much. Nothing really reaches the beach at all. So you can do a good Smokey Zooka run here. There are some mines I need to watch out for. Another reason why running on the side, too, in this case, would be because there's mines hidden behind different defenses, and you don't want your Zookas running over, because a couple mines will kill them. I'll kill a bunch of them. So what I'll do is I'm going to actually smoke to the actual right side and go up this right side, and then flare them over here after. That way they're avoiding all those mines. Okay, so here we go. Let's attack here, and let's take this guy out. And so first and foremost, I'm gonna barrage here because I'll get some of those gold storage boxes too. That'll be kind of cool. Why not, right? And then, ooh, maybe not. I hope an artillery will finish that off. Did I get him right? Oh, I didn't get him. Okay, no big deal, no big deal. So now we're gonna actually flare like we're flaring to a corner base. Nothing should hit me as I make my deployment. And my girls, if they're in a nice line like that, you did it right, guys. So as you see, I'm just releasing them, and I'm actually gonna flare way above here and throw some critters here to kind of distract and get those mines taken care of. And then now it's just a matter of getting our troops to the rendezvous point. Now the heavies are taking the lead right now, so I'm not gonna care if they run over those mines because it won't kill them. They have a ton of health. Okay, I'm actually gonna get rid of that shock mine, and then I'm actually gonna flare them right over to this location here. I didn't wait for my girls long enough, so I actually was not playing right. But fortunately, they did not. I forgot to take out that storage house. One more. Oh man, what is he doing? Okay, we gotta go for the core now. So I'm gonna actually shock, 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 shock. All right, there we go. My heavies have taken the lead. That flamethrower, when he comes back on, is gonna start frying my heavies, which is fine. But we're gonna take this base out, no problems. You look at my girls, the Zookas are protected. The heavies were the meat shields right there. I didn't lose one heavy, guys. I was close to, but I didn't lose any heavies there. And we take that general base out just like that, and we get a nice prototype module liking that. Only lost 12 girls, not too bad, not too bad at all. So moving on to Lucio, level 62 player here. His base is like right there. It's like he opened an area right here for my Zookas and heavies to just be. That's just awesome. Only problem is here, I'm gonna have machine guns in the back clipping my Zookas. So the best thing I need to do here is probably not go right there. He's probably like saying, ooh, You guys, it's like a trap. He wants you to go there. But technically, there's nothing in the back here to kill my Zookas. If I can place them right here, if I can get rid of these flamethrowers here and this mortar here with a double barrage, and I place my Zookas up in this area here, this rocket won't hit me because I'm in its actual radius of a free zone. I'll only have to shock him. And pretty much it. That's pretty much it. Nothing else to hit me. So let's get you right into this, guys. Sorry I'm talking so fast. I just don't want to make this video too long. So let's do this. I didn't see how much HP these flamethrowers had, but I guess it'll take three artilleries. Okay, perfect. And the rockets don't really hit. I don't, unless that one in the corner does. So what I'm gonna do here is flare my troops and put them right here. I'm gonna put out one smoke because there is a rocket in the corner that probably could reach my troops. Let's do that again. That was kind of a bad landing. But let's do this and move. And we're going to actually go up to this location here. I'm actually gonna need to critter those mines there. I totally forgot to do that. I want that shock mine out of commission. And then my troops, I just need to keep them straight in a line like they're doing just fine right now. And throw a med kit right here. Oh, there's a couple of them running out of the smoke there. We can't have that. Come on, Zookas. So I'm gonna flare them back in the smoke and then to the HQ. And then we're just going to that was kind of sloppy, guys. I should have went a little higher up here towards the sniper tower. But the job is done, and we are complete here. And boom, there we go. I will take a shard. Lost 11 girls, no heavies again. Again, I succeeded that. And we get another chest here. I will take those 6 shards. Thank you so much. Moving down the list here. Ooh, here's a bunch of people here. Let's take out Darisi, maybe I'm saying that right. I don't know. Here's a base, perfect. He is in the right corner, so I'm going to just attack here. And my goal is to take out the flamethrowers and mortars. And what's nice about the barrage going here, it's going to take out a bunch of mines, which is totally cool. I'm totally happy with that. And I will artillery that mortar there because he will do damage. And there we go. There, that's my placement right there. And I gotta shock that shock up there anyway, so I'll get the flamethrower, so not a big deal. And no troops can hit me, no weapons can hit me as my troops deploy, so I will deploy them as if I were doing all Zookas. So as you see here, there they go. Again, guys, you wanna hug the right side or left side at all costs. Let's get them up in that quadrant there. And I'm not gonna need the smoke. I got a few mines here. I'll just throw some critters there to maybe to throw off and distract for a second. And then now I'm gonna start smoking. So as you can see, they run beautifully up the right side when you do it this way, and you have no problem whatsoever. Now we do have a laser beam there. I can definitely shock that with the shocks. So once they, oh, I actually need a flare again because my flare was running out. And then I'm actually gonna flare back again and then do the core and then shock. Yes. Throw some med kits. Oh, I got mortars coming in, but it's okay, guys. We did take out this guy here, level 63, and boom, he's done. So there we go, got some intel, and lost 18 girls and a heavy there. Not too shabby, but not too good. Moving on to Ranger, let's check out Ranger and see what we can do with this guy here. He has a shield on his base. I'm trying to think here, let's see, he does have, I could take out this flamethrower here and land him here, and all I have is just one shot troops here. I could just shock this rocket and get this mortar and shock, and we could take him out easy. So let's do this, guys. Going right in. Now, if you look at this rocket, he can hit the beach. So I'm gonna have to do it the old fashioned way or just smoke him, but I'll show you the way I do it when I have to do it a different way. So let's get rid of this. I know it's gonna take 2 of them. Oh well. And then I'm actually going to, I'm gonna critter these mines here, artillery this one here, and then flare right here and send some critters out first so they get hit first, and get my troops out and just kind of cover them like in a triangular fashion until they all kind of meet. Flare them back and then right to the execution rendezvous point. And for the most part, they kind of stay in line and they do a good job. So that's the best way I think you can do that. And then I'm actually gonna back them up once again, flare this HQ, and throw some med kits on my girls, and let's take out this base, no problem. Look at the two blasts and that generator was gone, and another two blasts and the HQ was gone. So there we go, Ranger is gone. And so far with that Power Stone chance, I got that one crystal and that was it. Okay, whatever, it is what it is. Like I said, I don't know if that really truly works as great as they say it does, but we'll see. All right, let's take out G.E. Loyenway or Lineway or whatever. Let's check him out, level 62 here. Again, another shield on his base. He has a healthy one. So my best bet here is I have mortars here that will actually tag my troops if I place them on the right side of right here. But if I go on this side, machine guns, I only have machine guns. So I'm basically going to actually probably end up going up here towards the mortar and the machine gun. I'll get rid of them. And all I have to do is just shock the rocket here. Basically, probably not the, the rocket and the shock blaster will be shocked. And then I could just shock here the shock launcher. And that shock launcher's not even gonna fire because it's getting worked on. And this guy, I don't know about him because he'll hit my heavies. So let's see, anything can hit me. Yes, I got boom cannons that can probably reach depending on how far my boats deploy. But we're gonna actually do it the way I wanna do it. So up here, let's do a double barrage here on the mortar and machine gun. Maybe I'll take out some extra buildings for some GBE. Come on, oh really, come on now. Let's just do it right here with the double, there we go. And let's see, best pathway here is I'm going to just actually, let's flare right here. And let's let our troops out here as much as I can. Come on, come on. All right, girls land. And then I'm actually gonna flare them right actually to the rendezvous point now. I got my heavies getting hit right now. I'm actually gonna lay another critter box down. Oh, I kind of have them running out of the smoke there for just a little bit. That was kind of sloppy. I did lose some girls there. That was not good. Okay, 92 GBE. Let's get them all situated here. Flare back. Flare to the core. Shock. Shock. And yeah. Let's throw a med kit and watch my Zookas take this base down. So there we go, and didn't lose too many, but we did, and yeah, level 62 GI Loyenway is gone, and we take all his loot, or whatever I can take of it. So, all right, let's just clear this map. I think I'm almost done, guys, and let's check out this guy. This guy's, I think maybe he had his kid write his name, and look at all the letters and numbers. Maybe that's like a password to his bank account, I don't know. Okay, this base here has like nothing, no boost, no ice, no nothing. This should almost be like one blast with my Zookas. It'll be pretty fun to watch if I can get them all there without getting hit. But like I said, he has a shock blaster too here that can reach the beach, so I will deploy my special way. And I'm trying to think the best route to take here would probably be up here, like near the armory, because there's nothing above it except for this rocket that will hit my troops. Maybe I'll just blast it away. I'll wait until to shock it. What a waste of a shock, right? Okay, so here we go. Let's get rid of it. Let's throw a barrage right at the rocket. That should take it out, actually, because my barrages do like 14K damage. So that's good here. And let's get this flamethrower and armory knocked out. One more artillery. See you later. Okay, there we go. We are ready for deployment now. And I'm basically going to, like I say, I usually flare to the nearest building so my troops will stop. And I throw critters out first, and then we will deploy. And as you saw, that the shock blaster turned on the actual critters, so that was good. Now I'm gonna flare them back, and then flare them to the rendezvous point. I don't know why they're going to those mines there. I guess they have a death wish. But I'm gonna actually throw a med kit because they are running over the mines. Now the heavies, once they take the lead, I don't care about the mines anymore because they, again, have a lot of health and they do just great for my girls. So let's flare back and then to the HQ and start shocking. All right, here we go. Let's see, boom. Oh, it almost was one blast, you guys. It almost was one blast. I lost 4 heavies and 1 Zooka. 1 Zooka on that one. I thought it was gonna be just one blast and we would have had him. He did actually have ice. It was actually ice damage though, so not too bad. Okay, so there we go. Let's just clear here. Let's go to this guy now, level 63. Can't really pronounce his name. I don't know what it says, but this base is kind of interesting. Doesn't have any kind of shield generator or anything. So basically here, I see that there's a rocket there, a rocket there, and a rocket that's being worked on, which is great because it's gonna be out of play. So basically, I'm gonna get my troops up the right side since there's like nothing that can hit them except for that rocket when it gets to these trees here. So I'm gonna actually attack and I'm gonna do some damage so I can make a nice platform for my troops. I'm going to do like a double barrage here and just try to take out buildings so I can get some GBE back. There we go, boom cannon goes out and let's get this. I should have really went for this flamethrower here because he will be a pest. So there we go, that looks beautiful to me. And so with deployment now, I'm gonna actually, and there's no mines when they run up this right side, so that's kind of cool. I shouldn't have to really destroy mines, which is great. So I'm gonna run the right side, guys. Gonna use some smoke once they hit by those palm trees, because that's when the rocket's gonna kick in and it should be fun. So let's do this. Let's go way up to here now. And oh, they actually might hit that boom mine, one of those heavies. Oh, I smoked a little too early there. It's okay. But they're kind of running. But they're running enough and wide enough to where I can smoke and they don't come out of the smoke. So just running and running. Okay, the Zookas, obviously you can see, are a little bit behind here. So I'm gonna actually flare back in this area here. And then actually flare up above and begin the smoking treatment here. Boom, oh, okay. A couple of Zookas kinda got shocked there in that shock. And that heavy is just sticking out like a sore thumb, I tell ya. So flare back and flare the HQ. Let's shock and shock and shock, and then just blast the base down, no problem. I did lose 3 Zookas and 2 heavies on this one, not too bad. Again, you guys, not the cleanest, but the job got done, no problem. And that goes there. So doing pretty good here, Smokey Hooka, all the way through these bases, guys. Just tearing these guys up one by one. Let's go see Charbel, let's see him, level 61 here. Does have a shield, so let's see what we can do here. The best place to probably go would be up here where this boom cannon is, because if inside the rocket pocket, new term, rocket pocket, hashtag rocket pocket. We can put him right there where the boom cannon is, and then basically just obviously we'll shock here because that flamethrower will be hitting my Zooka, so that shock blaster and flamethrower would be shocked. This shock and these flamethrowers and machine guns would be shocked. I'd have to shock this guy because he would get my Zookas. And then probably one more shock if I have enough GBE for these two here, and we're pretty much golden. So let's do that. And so how much do we have here? We have a barrage and an artillery, and we should be good. Okay, here we go, guys. Trying to make this video as quick as possible so we can get done. An artillery and a barrage should be enough, I'm hoping. Boom, okay, good. And the rockets, I didn't test their thing here, I don't know. I'll just do it like I normally would if I had to do that. So I'm gonna actually flare here, let some critters out there and there, and then go to town here, smoking my troops to that point. And once they bunch up, that Zooka is just sticking out of there like that. And now we're gonna actually flare now. I'm actually gonna throw some med kits here. See, like now my Zookas are running. See, they kind of ran a little messy, guys. See, that's why I don't care too much for going straight up, because they do kind of run around buildings differently at times. They kind of do their own thing, but it's okay. I got most of my troops there, and I plan to take this base out. So here we go. I'm actually going to shock here, shock here, shock here, shock here. Actually, I don't have enough shocks left, but I have confidence. Yes, we are blasting that HQ down. No problem. Yes, it'll be toast soon enough. Soon enough. And there it goes, guys. Did lose a lot more troops than I really wanted to lose. But it is down in Charbel. Thank you so much for the loot. Look at, he has some ice statues, guys. He did have some ice statues. Now, I'm boosted as well. I'm fully boosted, so I owe a lot to my boost here. Unboosted, I probably couldn't be taking these bases down, especially if they have ice and a generator and a shield. So there we go. Let's check out this guy here, level 61. Again, he has his base up in the right-hand side. My the best location if taking him out, heavy Zooka. It seriously is. So basically, I'm just gonna jump right into this, guys. And again, I usually use double barrage when I'm heavily boosted, because if you see my GB, I'm at 162. And I'm gonna actually go barrage here. I'm looking to get these machine guns and the flamethrower right there, and I did just that. And you know what? I might as well just artillery and get rid of this flamethrower, because it'll just make my life a lot easier in the long run. There we go. And that's just, nothing can hit my troops on deployment, so I'm going to just freely deploy them on the beach as I would normally doing this troop combination deployment. And there we go. And then last but not least, I'm gonna actually flare them to the rendezvous point. Throw a critter box out ahead of them and begin my Smokey Hooka travels. So here we go here. Let's see, and keep smoking away. So 92 GBE left in there. I love when my heavies lead, because they run over the mines and mow down the mines for my Zookas. And then I'm gonna flare one more time, because my flare was running out, and then flare right to the HQ. Shock, 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 critter. And then here we go. Blasting away this HQ, and it's, we'll throw another med kit. I like to throw med kits on my Zookas, because when the rockets do hit them, if you have multiple med kits on them, they heal so quick the rockets can't kill them. It's really cool. But anyways, we took care of that base, you guys, and down he goes, and only lost four Zookas, and I won a ton of gold. I am like, I should be upgrading something right now. What can I upgrade? Anything? How about this? How about my sniper tower to level 21? No, I can't yet. Close, but I can't. That's the new sniper tower I got for getting my HQ 22, by the way. So let's get our girls. Let's see, anybody else on this map? Yes, there's one, two. Yeah, there's two more bases left. Let's get this level 60 here. Gosh, look how much gold this guy has. He has a ton of gold. I need to take this one from him easy. Oh, he has no boost on him, but he's way up there at the top, guys. Way up there at the top. Not a big deal. This rocket can't even, it can reach, but I don't think it's gonna be a problem. Not too bad here. This rocket here can kind of reach, but not really a problem. Got this shock and mortar to worry about, this rocket and machine gun to worry about, and we are golden. Let's do this, and let's get rid of that flamethrower up there. He has a lot of trees. I wonder if my troops are gonna like go all crazy running through the trees. I heard they do, so I'm hoping that they don't, but I know they do. So let's just get rid of that boom mine there. I'm just trying to use what I can. I have that rocket launcher that can probably almost reach the beach. I got boom cannons up front, but we're gonna actually, I'm gonna try something here. I'm gonna actually smoke right between this cannon and boom cannon here, and then from there actually to the rendezvous point, because it's just long run. So let's see if I can make it that. Hope that rocket can't hit my troops. The boom cannons might fire, probably will. Maybe, if not, that would be great. I would really appreciate not hitting my troops right now. And then I'm actually gonna flare them right over there, throw some critters out, and oh, he did shoot at one of my troops, and did he get one? Yeah, he got a Zooka. Oh, it's okay, totally okay. Now here comes the trees. I'm gonna see how they run here. Hopefully it's not too crazy. It's very smart to have trees on your base, because it does cause a stir. It does. Okay, I'm gonna actually flare there one more time, because it is running out, and then to the rendezvous point. Let's see how they run in a diagonal here. I gotta be very precise with my smokes, because I don't wanna die. Okay, as you can see, they're running just fine. Like, a couple Zookas might run out, but it's okay. No, we got there in one kit and caboodle, so there we go, guys. I'm gonna flare back in the smoke, flare. I'm actually gonna shock what I was gonna shock, and then let some critters out, and this one should go down easy money. I did lose a few girls on that one and no heavies, so I'm happy to say that. That wasn't long run, guys. When they're up that high, you need a lot of GBE to get up there successfully. So I did have that, and I only lost five Zooka girls. So moving right on, and I think this is the last guy here. A level 55. What? A level 55? Has a lot of loot, though. I will take it. A lot of loot. And look at these boom cannons. A level one boom cannon. I haven't seen one of those in a long time. This is kind of cool. This brings me back. It's like retro Boom Beach for me. So what I'm looking here, the best avenue to take here is I have a machine gun here. He's not going to really do much damage if I threw a med kit on my girl, so I'm not really worried about him. But if I did barrage, I'd get a lot of buildings and get some GBE. I might do that just to get some extra GBE. And then put him up there at the top here and call it a day with this guy here. So Tara Watat, I don't know. Anyways, let's do this. The rockets do kind of reach. That shock launcher does reach, then the boom cannons do definitely reach. So yeah, let's do it, guys. Let's go and get this base. Minimal casualty loss, right? That's what we're looking for. So I'm actually gonna throw a big barrage right there, and I'm hoping to get some buildings that will reimburse me, and not too much, but it's okay. And then I'm actually gonna rock out this sniper tower and flamethrower. One more artillery should do the trick. And it does. And basically here, I'm going to flare to this sniper tower, send out some critters to actually get rid and get on that. Oh my goodness, I just threw a bunch of critters. I need to retreat because I just wasted all my GBE. Yeah, I didn't switch to my troops, and that's what happened. So that guy's gonna watch that video and say, look at that knucklehead. He just threw a bunch of critters out. Yeah, anyways, you guys all saw what happened. It was by accident. Let's try this barrage again and throw it right there and see if we get a better output this time. Let's see. There we go. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, better. Last time it was 161 GB. Now we got 164. I will take it. So I will flare here. I will critter and critter. Oh, I forgot to actually get rid of that. That just wasted. So let's just do this. And I'm going to hurry it this time. See, when you don't put critters out, they immediately target your troops. But there, I was pretty safe from it. And then I'm actually gonna wait till they get there, flare back a little bit, and then begin my smoky travels here. I kinda like watch when I smoke them back to where they're gonna run, because that way it leads me to find a smoky path to choose. So I'm gonna do two more smokes here, just to be safe. Got 88 GBE left, you guys. I'm gonna throw a med kit right on my flare point there. I'm actually going to, some of my girls stepped out. So, and then move right back and start shocking everything and throwing a med kit, and then just look at all those girls just fire those rockets, and we take out this base. It's level 55. I lost more troops than I really wanted to, but it's okay. We took it out. Minimal troop loss. Not bad. Not bad. And we get a bunch of gold and resources. I will take that. Thank you, level 55. I'm sorry I took a lot of your loot away. But let's see, what can I upgrade now? Anything? Anything at all? I can't even upgrade this yet? Really? For that? Why not? That way I can't lose that many resources when somebody raids my base. Well, I'm back at 806, guys. I'm just, 14 away from getting back my marshal status. Let me see, what did I get over here? I have 276 power powders left and just a bunch of stuff in progress here. So there we go. There we go, there we go. I do have a bunch of NPC bases I could take out, and I have to take Dr. T out as well. I will probably do that with warriors just to get it done quick, because I'll do that later. It's too long of a video to do it. But I do have a bunch of NPC bases I could definitely clear and probably make it back to the Marshal rank 1 status. So I will do that later. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. You guys are awesome. Reversal, thanks again so much for all your encouragement, buddy. You are awesome. Stay awesome, buddy. And I will see you guys soon, and I will catch you guys later. All right, bye-bye.